So now we learn in an about face, the White House says it will sign a bill on the Iran nuclear deal that will give Congress the final say in this matter. Now, both Republicans and Democrats on board that. Earlier today, I talked with the Republican presidential candidate, Senator Marco Rubio, about that and other things. Marco Rubio is back with us. And Senator, good morning to you from Capitol Hill.
Good morning.
On Iran, the vote was 19-0 in this committee. What does that tell the president?
I think it tells the president that there's a strong, almost unanimous bipartisan consensus in the Senate that the Senate has to play a role in this deal. In fact, what the president is asking for is he wants to unilaterally lift sanctions under a national security waiver built into the original sanctions bill. And what Congress is saying is we want to have a role in preventing you from doing that if we don't think this deal is good enough. And what it's very clear is that while we may disagree about the specifics of what that sort of process should look like, the enormous majority of Republicans and Democrats in the United States Senate believe that the Congress must play a role in overseeing and providing oversight on the deal.
And I think that is clear. And listening to Bob Corker talk about it, I think you're exactly right about that. But in the big picture, what does this now say about Iran's capacity to go nuclear?
About the deal in general? Mm-hmm. The deal will allow them to keep in place the infrastructure they will need to one day build a weapon. And by the way, a weapons program for Iran isn't just the enrichment of uranium or the reprocessing of plutonium. It's a bomb design, which they could literally buy from multiple countries or individuals around the world. It's a delivery system, for example, a long-range rocket, which is not even part of this conversation. And they continue to aggressively build up their abilities to construct long-range rockets, one day capable of reaching the United States. Those things are untouched by this deal. And they're going to keep infrastructure, critical infrastructure, that at some point in the future they could flip the switch on and build a bomb. And that's what I'm most concerned about. I think it almost guarantees that at some point they'll move forward in that direction.
Wow. Guarantees?
Yeah, there's no doubt in my mind that the radical Shia cleric, they call the supreme leader that governs Iran, wants Iran to have the capability not just to hold America hostage, but to destroy the state of Israel. I believe that because he has said it. And I think if someone continuously says they want to destroy Israel, we should start believing them.
Yeah. I think a lot of people are left shaking their head because even Steny Hoyer, a House Democrat leader on the House side, said there is not a framework. So it just seems like both sides are talking past each other yet again on this. So more to come on that. Now on Cuba, what's the big crime in taking that country off the state-sponsored terrorist list?
Well, first of all, Cuba now harbors dozens of fugitives of American justice. Those include people that have stolen millions of dollars in taxpayer money through Medicare fraud. They're now on the island of Cuba enjoying that money. That includes a cop killer, a woman that killed a police officer in New Jersey, someone on the 10 most wanted list by the FBI. Second, Cuba is the country that helped North Korea try to evade UN sanctions. They were caught just a year ago trying to do that. It's a country that gives material support to the revolutionary group inside Colombia, a terrorist group. And in addition to that, this is a country that has two high military officials that have been indicted by a U.S. federal grand jury for being involved in the murder of two U.S. citizens, pilots of Brothers to the Rescue, who were shot down over international airspace. So this, they have all the elements of a terrorist sponsor nation.
Yeah, and you want to be president. And if you were president, what would you do on Cuba?
They would go right back on that list.
What would be your policy?
Well, first of all, Cuba would go back on the state sponsor of terrorism list. Second of all, I would move aggressively through using radio and TV Marti platforms to actually deliver not just content, but access to the Cuban people, to the internet, through wireless technologies, using satellite technology, things the Cubans cannot block, the Cuban government cannot block. And third, I would increase the support to democracy groups within the island of Cuba so that we can build a strong civil society prepared to help to guide that country in a democratic direction when Raul and Fidel Castro exit the scene, as they will invariably here soon. They're both over 80 years of age.
Yeah, and Senator, thank you for your time. There's more to talk about.
You.
We'll get another opportunity again soon. Thank you. Marco Rubio from Washington Today.